This is Face the Music, an Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast. Episode 153. It really doesn't matter.
I spent some time across the waves. I learned a lot of things I never could. I waved my magic wand over the past I never understood. It really doesn't matter at all. It really doesn't matter at all. If you found what you're looking for, it really doesn't matter.
What's that song all about?
It Really Doesn't Matter is the eighth track on Zoom. On the 2001 Sony Jeff Lynne interview disc, Jeff said,
I wrote that on a beach in the Bahamas, actually, on a little wooden guitar that Danny Farrington made, like a travel guitar, and it just fits in your suitcase, it's about that big, and it's a lovely little thing, just made out of scrap wood, and it plays really well, and I just went walking down the beach writing it, and Rosie was with me, and that's where it came from. And what it really means, really doesn't matter at all, is that if you're all right, it really doesn't matter at all. You know, you can moan all you like about everything, but, you know, if the main things are all right, then you ain't doing too bad. Maybe I'm more optimistic than I used to be, or pessimistic even.
When we're together, darling, every night is Halloween.
Hi, I'm Eric Winsenson.
And I'm Eric Paul Johnson.
And, well, I've come to the conclusion that it really doesn't matter.
Well, there's a point in everybody's life where they think it really doesn't matter anymore.
No, it really doesn't.
No.
So, I'm going to grab the toaster, and I'm going to make some toast, and I'm going to sit back and watch a movie.
In the bathtub?
No, I'm not going to waste a good toaster in the bathtub.
You make a valid point. Yeah.
But, actually, the song makes me very, very happy.
Oh.
I guess he was happy when he wrote it, but the reason it makes me happy is because after the last few songs, I'm like, hey, this is really pretty good. And I guess he was sitting there playing it on some little tiny guitar on a beach in the Bahamas, you know, like, well, things that people like us will never experience. Sitting on the beach with a model and playing his guitar, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I got a lottery ticket, and my wife is friends with a model, so it could work out. For me, anyway.
Your wife is friends with a model?
Oh, yeah. God, she's hot. The model. Hmm. Well, the wife works for me, too.
I was about to say. This is the last broadcast of...
Wait, hold on. I'm hearing steps stomping down the hall.
Oh, boy. But back to the song.
Yes.
I wasn't expecting this. I was expecting a song because too often calling a song, it doesn't really matter. It's not a good title for a song because it makes the listener feel right then and there, well, it doesn't really matter if I listen to this song, does it? Well, this one, it's a happy-go-lucky song, and even though it was written on a little tiny guitar, what really sells it is when you get that nice, crunchy electric rhythm guitar that comes in between the verses, and then you get an electric guitar solo. And first time I heard that, I went, God, I hope he does this right and does this on the next time. And he does! And he does it again. And it's like, oh, good, he put this together the way it really should be. Lyrically, it's just one of those don't worry, be happy type songs. But musically, and the way he delivers the vocals, really love the vocal delivery on this. it's good to hear this because I was starting to go, oh boy, this album is really starting to drag. And then this comes along, so it really made me happy to hear this on here because this is something that, it's like some of the earlier songs, it's something that would actually sell the album to me.
Well, you surprised me. I expected you not to like this. I thought you'd be bored with this. I had this preamble all lined up in my head that there are people who will get upset when a critic gives their opinion about a song. And I was going to go off on that. It's just an opinion. What somebody thinks about a song. You know, that's what this person thinks. If you like something, you should keep on liking it. And that was going to be the basis of my rant. I mean, basically, critics are entertainment. If they can write or say a critique in a way that's fun to read or listen to, then it's purely for entertainment, because what they like doesn't make a difference to what you like. So, I guess the point that I was trying to make is that what me and you say here, it really doesn't matter at all. And that was going to segue into what I thought of the song. But now that I've heard you gush about this song, I kind of don't want to do it, or didn't want to do it, because I didn't want to pee all over your glowing review. For me, I'm not saying I don't like the song. It's fine. It's got a nice catchy tune. But it comes at a point in the album where it makes me think, I'm really trying to like this album. It's fine if it comes on and I listen to it. It's really okay. And then when it's over, it's like, all right, that was over. I really don't have a burning desire to hear it again. But it's a pleasant song. But it's not so much so that it's not an S-J-I-G-H. Sweet Jesus. I gotta hear, it really doesn't matter at all. I like the guitar solo. I think that's great. It plays backwards at first, and then it goes into a different guitar effect on the other half of the guitar solo. But as for the rest of it, not bad. Not something I'd go back to, but if it comes on, I'll just kind of, yeah, that was nice, and then move on.
Kind of like I felt about Easy Money.
I do like this one better than Easy Money.
Oh, I definitely like this one much more than Easy Money.
Yeah.
Well, this is one of those things, I complained about songs where you fall in love and you want to make songs about the person that you're in love with.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you fall in love and you're actually trying to express the emotions that you're happy and everything and not writing something sickly sweet,
yeah,
this is what comes out. Because, I'm walking along the beach, life is good. I got a little tiny guitar, a teeny tiny little guitar. And I'm tapping that when I get back, and beer. I'm talking about beer.
See, I thought you were talking about playing the guitar. Tapping that guitar.
Yeah, doing the tapping style.
He's getting some music out of it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, lyrically, I can totally get behind it. I will have to go do things to get money, and sometimes it goes badly, and I just get really cranky. But I get to go home to the wife and kid, and desperately avoiding Hallmark saccharine, that's nice. As before in my past, where it was like, I am going to burn this place to the ground, and I'm just going to walk away. Instead, when I get something else going on that's much nicer, you know, it really doesn't matter at all that somebody's at the place is being a real jackass to me or something like that. Because I get to go away from this later on to boobies, and that's always nice.
That's romantic.
But this song, the Electric Orchestra song, is something that I wouldn't have minded if they played a bit back when this came out.
Yeah, no, I'm perfectly fine with hearing this anytime over Aqualung. Or Stairway to Heaven. It's just, okay, I heard it. That was nice. What else we got?
Got something to say about It Really Doesn't Matter? Then call the telephone line voicemail.
623-850-3375. Call now.
Great moments in Electric Light Orchestra history.
In the beginning, ELO's music was labeled classical rock by a lot of critics because of the use of strings, and says his most important musical inspiration came from his teenage love for rock and roll.
I don't read music or anything. I just got a guitar that was a plastic one, actually, the first one I had, off a friend of mine. He had it since he was a little kid. And I learnt a few tunes on one string up and down the neck. I only had one string on it. Just taught myself. But I used to watch local groups, you know, playing round about. One of them was a group called the Night Riders that I used to watch when I couldn't play. And the lead guitarist in that group, they used to play local in Birmingham. And this would be when I was about 15. And he used to let me have a go on his guitar. I used to be a cheeky lad and say, "Can I have a go on your guitar, please?" And he'd show me a couple of chords and things, and I'd rush home, because by then I'd got a Spanish guitar, you know, a little cheap one that my father had bought me, cost about £5 or something. Really hard action. It was hard to play. Make your fingers bleed, you know, all that sort of thing. It was just so fabulous to be able to play a tune on a guitar, you know. It was just, you see these people on TV and they could play and you go, "Oh, fantastic." And I went to these little local dance things in Birmingham and saw these groups playing live there, and I just couldn't believe that ordinary people could do that. You know, I was still astounded that these blokes actually could speak, you know, and I was talking to them and they'd let me have a go on the guitar. It was just like a total thrill, the whole thing. And for the next, you know, 3 years or so, that's all I ever did, was just play guitar all day and all night.
Throw some cash our way at patreon.com/ELOpod. For $1 an episode, you can hear episodes a week before they post to the world. At the $2 per episode level, you get expanded episodes heard only on Patreon, reviews from Don Fields, the Eric's Cover ELO cover songs, or skip all that and just hand it over directly through PayPal using the email address eloftmpodcast@gmail.com.
In your ear like a bad Q-tip. This is Dr. Troy with my thoughts on It Really Doesn't Matter. Well, I don't hate this song, but I don't like it all that much either. It's a nice song. I do think that if it had been released in the 70s or 80s when 45s were still a thing, that it probably would have ended up as a B-side, and a good B-side at that. But having said that, there is one thing that I really love about this song, other than its nice sing-along melody. I really love the way the tempo picks up after each verse. I love that guitar riff that comes in, and then that nice guitar solo that follows that. It's almost the reverse of what Jeff did on In My Own Time, where the thing I liked about that song was, if you recall, that each verse began the same way, with Jeff starting to sing and then the melody kicking in. I thought that gave that song something special that otherwise would have made it filler, and I think the tempo change at the end of each verse on this song does the same. It's a song that could have been filler, but it ends up being a not-so-bad album track. Well, I'll talk to you next week. This has been a thought from Dr. Troy.
Like it, hate it, what does Madeline think?
Hi guys, and I like this song.
Wow, she liked it!
Face the Music, an Electric Light Orchestra song-by-song podcast, is a production of Radio Trolla Entertainment, Assorted Deli Meets Amalgamated. You can contact us by voicemail at 623-850-3375 or email us at eloftmpodcast@gmail.com. Keep up to date on the show by joining our Facebook group and spread the word by sharing the link or giving us a quick rating on iTunes. You can financially support the podcast at patreon.com/ELOpod. Next week, episode 154, Ordinary Dream.
That is such a stupid thing to say.
It doesn't matter at all, I don't care, it doesn't matter at all, Jeff Lynne.